Psalm 22:26 says, "The meek shall eat and be satisfied. They shall praise the Lord that seek Him, and your heart shall live forever." Dr. Robert G. Lee has reminded us that Jesus is the theme of the Old Testament and also as the New in the New Testament. The Old Testament He is promised, and in the New Testament He is presented. Psalm 22 is one of those prophetic psalms that Jesus had in mind when He spoke these words in Luke 24:44. "These are the words which I spake unto you while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled which were written in the law of Moses and in the prophets and in the Psalms concerning me." In Psalm 22, Jesus is introduced as the Good Shepherd. In Psalm 23, He is the Great Shepherd. And in Psalm 24, He is the Chief Shepherd. The 23rd Psalm is a bridge from the suffering of Psalm 22 to the glories of Psalm 24. The suffering of Jesus in the first 10 verses of 22 says this: my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Why art thou so far from helping me and from the wounds, words of my roaring? O my God, I cry in the daytime, but thou hearest not, in the night season, and am not silent, but thou art holy, O thou that inhabitest the praises of Israel. Our fathers trusted in thee, they trusted, and thou didst deliver them. They cried unto thee and were delivered, they trusted in thee and were not confounded. But I am a worm and no man, a reproach of men and despised of the people. All they that see me laugh me to scorn, they shoot out the lip, they shake the head, saying, he trusted on the Lord that he would deliver him. Let him deliver him, seeing he delighted in him. But thou art he that took me out of the womb. Thou didst make me hope when I was upon my mother's breast. I was cast upon thee from the womb. Thou art my God from my mother's belly. The prophetic words of this psalm is concerning Jesus Christ. This passage is the fulfillment in the New Testament, or most surely what Jesus had in mind when he so quoted from the Old Testament. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? In Mark 15:34, we have the fulfilling of that question. Here it says, "And at the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, which is being interpreted, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" You see, it was prophesied in Psalm 22, fulfilled in Mark chapter 15 in the New Testament. Jesus was the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world, and the reason he cried out, "Why hast thou forsaken me?" He had the sin of the whole world placed upon him. All those that had lived prior to his crucifixion, and everyone that would live after his crucifixion and resurrection, he had the sins of the entire world upon him. And God, being holy and righteous and pure, cannot stand to look upon sin. And that's why Jesus felt so lonely and so forsaken at Calvary. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? And we find that 10 centuries or 1,000 years before Jesus cried these words from the cross, the psalmist sang them in Psalm 22. And you tell me the Bible is just another book? No, the Bible is the inspired word of God, the rule of faith and conduct for all those who put their trust in Jesus Christ. In verse 7 of Psalm 22, "All they that see me laugh me to scorn. They shoot out the lip, they shake the head, and they passed by and railed on him, wagging their heads." Mark 15:29 is the fulfilling of the 7th verse of the 22nd Psalm. And Psalm 22 in verse 8 says, "He trusted on the Lord that he would deliver him, seeing he delighted in him." When the prophetic hymn came to pass, Matthew recorded it in Matthew 27:43. He said, he trusted in God, let him deliver him now, if he will have him. For he said, I am the Son of God. Jesus was who he claimed to be.
Amen.
He was the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the whole world, if they will accept him. And that's what John the Baptist cried when he saw Jesus coming on the shores of Lake Galilee. He says, behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. In verse 14 of Psalm 22, I am poured out like water. And 1,000 years later, John recorded it in the 19th chapter in verse 34. But one of the soldiers with a spear pierced his side, and forthwith came there blood and water. See, the New Testament is the fulfilling of the Old Testament. It did not replace it. It did not make it obsolete. It simply fulfilled the wonderful prophetic promises that were given in the Old Testament.
Amen.
In verse 14 of Psalm 22, my bones are out of joint. John recorded the fulfilling of this prophetic note when he recorded the crucifixion of our Lord in John 19:32-33. And this is what it says. Then came the soldiers and brake the legs of the first and of the second, which was crucified with him. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was dead already, they brake not his leg. He says, my bones are out of joint, but they were not broken. You see, he is the sacrifice. He is the propitiation for our sin. There is no other name given under heaven whereby we can be saved except the name of Jesus. Because he was the sinless sacrifice. He was the Passover sacrifice. He was the one through whom salvation came and is still coming today, that everyone that will accept him can receive. In verse 15, verse of Psalm 22, he says, my strength is dried up like a potsherd. My tongue cleaveth in my jaws, and thou hast brought me into the dust of death. But upon the cross Jesus cried, I thirst, John 19:18. And in Psalm 22:16, he says, they pierced my hands and my feet.
Amen.
This came to pass on Calvary. Luke records the post-resurrection evidence like this in Luke 24:39. Behold my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Handle me and see, for a spirit hath not flesh and bones, as ye see me have. You see, Jesus fulfilled every prophecy that was prophesied concerning him. If they had not every one been fulfilled, then someone would have been a false prophet. But Jesus fulfilled all of those. And we could go on. He says in verse 17 of Psalm 22, I can't tell all of my bones. They look and stare upon me. In other words, I'm like bones or a skeleton with skin stretched over that they can tell where every bone is. In the 18th verse, he says, they part my garments among them and cast lots upon my vesture. And again, Matthew clearly records the answer to this, or the actual events, in Matthew 27:35. And they crucified him and parted his garments, casting lots, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet. They parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture did they cast lots. Here are 9 sets of parallel prophecies and fulfilling of the prophecies. One foretold in the Old Testament and fulfilled in the New Testament. They span the centuries in magnificent unity and beauty. And who could doubt the divine inspiration of the Scriptures for such as this?
Amen.
The salvation is only by Jesus Christ, verse 21 of Psalm 22. There are at least 2 facets of salvation suggested here. One, save me from the lion's mouth. This is verse 21. Here is pictured the imprisonment of the soul that is sinner, or the soul that is in sin. We are caught. We are trapped. We are held captive and victim in the lion's mouth. And it's only through Jesus Christ,
amen,
setting us free from this entrapment.